and he's feeling good and in a rhythm, he's got protection, he can do some wonderful things. He can do everything that you want him to do at the pro level. The problem is consistency. The problem is decision-making. The problem is accuracy. The problem is poise under pressure, game management. It's seasoning. It's reps. It's experiencing crucial situations. Those are the kinds of things that right now teams had a lot of problems with as far as Deshone Kizer is concerned and why he slipped. Hugh Jackson's got his work cut out for him now. He's the quarterback whisperer. He's the guy. He's the reason why they hired him in Cleveland. He's going to have to now take him from A to Z and groom him to be the pro type of quarterback that Cleveland needs and deserves.
Yeah, season opener against Texas, he looked like a future for a top 15, top 10 pick, and then kind of went downhill, and you can't blame it on not having Will Fuller, you can't blame it on not having a left tackle like Ronnie Stanley. There's some throws that were majorly off target, holds the ball way too long, even about decision-making, then accuracy. My question is, guys, why do you come out after a mediocre year? If you can't get it done as a quarterback in college, what would make you think you could get it done at the pro level? It was mind-boggling to me that you would even think about leaving college early. I understand that you think about, okay, was he always going to be the guaranteed guy? There was other players there.